It's a great day for Auckland. 100 years after the first plans were drawn, the harbour bridge is ready for opening.
Auckland's making big strides in the area of, you know, becoming more efficient in transport. It probably started, the big step was in about 2005. I used to sit on the Regional Land Transport Committee then. And it was at that point we took a decision to focus more on public transport. And now our strategic direction is in favour of public transport, and that's particularly mass transit. That's rail, busway, they're the big two, particularly rail. And then active transport, and the big focus there is on cycling. We're seeing the dividends flowing through now with just quite significant numbers of Aucklanders going towards bus, rail and ferry, particularly the first two. In terms of Auckland supporting the nation, it's critical. There's no question about it. Some cities are becoming more important than the nations they belong to.
I would choose public transport over private options like a car, because it's just so much easier when you live in Devonport to get ferried to the city rather than drive. It takes too long. There have been a lot of problems recently with the Kia being out of action and overcrowding and delayed ferries. So, yeah, it's not brilliant. I have considered using other methods of transport to work, and sometimes I do take the car if I'm travelling off-peak. If I'm not in at work till 11 or I've got to leave early, then I take the car. It is quicker than the ferry.
The ferry space is one that we struggle with, and it's disappointing that we have seen competitors come in on the Waiheke run, Explore. It looked like they were doing well, but they've recently folded. I've been trying to lure a few more competitors on the Devonport run, but not to be. Fullers, to be honest, need an absolute good hard kick up the backside, and they're getting that, but we're not helped by the lack of government regulations.
I think the infrastructure in Auckland could be improved so much. There are so many things they could do to change it. First of all, they could just sort out their crap with all the buses not showing up on time, because people got to get places, and that's the only way they can sometimes. I also think they could maybe start having bigger buses arrive and organise better school buses for people going into Takapuna, because we don't have that one anymore and people are always trying to cram onto the public bus. When a bus is late, because I have to catch two buses, that means I'll be late for my other bus. A bus that's 5 minutes late will mean that I'm an hour late, and then I'll come to class and I'll get told off.
There's just an absolute thirsting, huge appetite amongst Aucklanders to climb aboard modern, you know, contemporary public transport, make sure it's frequent, make sure it's comfortable, make sure there's plenty of it, and they will climb aboard, and they'll keep climbing aboard if we keep providing. And that's my commitment.
Having recently gone on the New York subway, although that seems a very old system that doesn't look new and shiny at all like Shanghai's transport, I think that works pretty well. I'm not a big train user. The few times I have been on a train, it seems very efficient, and Britomart station looks very impressive and nice and shiny. So yeah, all I could say was I just hope the improvements they're doing are working for the people who use the trains a lot.
The City Rail Link is the clincher. It's the absolute game changer for transport in Auckland. And it's not just about the city centre, even though that City Rail Link is the unlocker of the city centre. It's the one project, and it's a $2.5 billion project that has taken 93 years to come about. That City Rail Link binds Auckland. It binds the whole network at its core. One for me, in terms of the upgrades on the horizon that I'd like to see happen, is I'm working now on a plan for light rail coming to the shore. And that's likely to be either on the existing Harbour Bridge, but probably more likely through a dedicated tunnel coming out at the Esmond Road interchange there. I've been working on the Skypath for 10 years, and that walking and cycling link over the Harbour Bridge is not far away. I would say we should be all doing that in 2018. And then light rail, for me, is the pick to connect the primary mode, to connect shore people to the city and beyond, and to connect those that are on the south side and in the city to travel to the shore for employment, for recreation, or for whatever their call is to come to the shore. I'm picking that it is a light rail solution. So I'd rest my case on a light rail connection, and I think we could see that in place by late 20s. Late 20s for light rail, Skypath connection 2018.